Hello, my dear student. This is Rishi Singh, and you are watching me on our new YouTube channel, Saint Xavier's School, Hardoi. Student, if you have not subscribed our new YouTube channel, Saint Xavier's School, Hardoi, please subscribe it and press the bell icon for getting upcoming videos and notifications.
Dear student, today we are going to discuss Chapter 2 of History, and the name of the chapter is The Regional Kingdoms. Students, now I am going to explain what are regional kingdoms. Students, a regional kingdom is a series of city-states combined into one powerful kingdom. And you know, they had to organize from a small level to a huge one. Students, there were many regional kingdoms in India in the early medieval period. What is medieval period? That I will tell you. Medieval period can be divided into two periods. Number one, early medieval period, and number two, the late medieval period. And you know, student, the early medieval period lasted from 6th to the 13th century, and the late medieval period lasted from 13th to the 16th century. Students, there were many dynasties in these kingdoms. Some of the dynasties are in this way: the Pala dynasty, Gurjara Pratihara dynasty, Chahmanaz or Chauhan's dynasty, the Rashtrakutas dynasty, Rajput dynasty, Pallava dynasty, etc. The Pala dynasty. You know, students, Suleiman was an Arab merchant who visited India in the 9th century. And you know, he was the person who termed the Pala Empire as Rumi. This empire was founded by Gopala. It means Gopala was the first ruler of this dynasty. You know, he was elected as the king by the noblemen of the region. You know, students, the Pala dynasty dominated eastern India from the middle of the 8th century to the middle of the 19th century. And you know, Nalanda University was also revived by a Pala ruler whose name was Dharmapala. He also founded the famous Vikramshila University on the banks of the Ganga in Magad. Students, now let us know about the Gurjar Pratihar dynasty. Students, Gurjar Pratihar dynasty dominated western India and the upper Gangetic Valley till the middle of the 10th century. And you know, students, Pratihars were also called Gurjar Pratihars because they originated from Gujarat or southwest Rajasthan. Students, it is believed that originally they were a branch of the Gurjars, which was one of the nomadic Central Asian tribes that poured into India along with the Hunas. And students, this dynasty was founded by King Mihir Bhoj, and he was popularly known as Bhoj. Students, it's very important to know that as rulers, the Pratihars came into prominence in the middle of the 8th century. And students, at that time, their king was Nagbhat I. Students, after the reign of Nagbhat I, the Pratihars suffered a lot. Why they suffered a lot? Because they were defeated by Rashtrakutas. Students, the Pratihars regained their lost glory after the succession of King Mihir Bhoj. Students, King Mihir Bhoj was succeeded by his son Mahendra Pala I. Now students, let us know about the Chahmans or Chauhan dynasty. Students, the word Chauhan is the vernacular form of the Sanskrit term Chahman. Students,
The Chauhans formed their ruling dynasties at various places. Students, the major Chauhan dynasties are in this way: Chauhans of Shakambhari, Chauhans of Ranthambore, and Chauhans of Jalore. Students, the Chauhans originally had their kingdom at Shakambhari, present day Sambhar Lake. The Chauhan dynasty ruled Shakambhari region in 11th century. Students, the great Rajputs were the kings of Chauhan dynasty. The kings of this dynasty were known for their bravery and loyalty. Students, in the early 12th century, Ajay Raja II moved the kingdom's capital to Ajaymeru, modern Ajmer. Students, that was why the Chauhan rulers are also known as the Chauhans of Ajmer. They fought several wars with their neighbors. Students, Rajputs of this dynasty ruled over the regions of Delhi and Ajmer. Prithvi Raj Chauhan was the most famous ruler of this dynasty. He defeated Muhammad Ghori, the Afghan ruler, in 1191, but he was defeated by Ghori in 1192. Students, now I am going to explain the Rajputas dynasty. First of all, I will tell meaning of the word Rajputas. Students, the word Rajputas has been derived from Sanskrit word. Rashtra means country and Kuta means chief. Students, the Rajputas dynasty was one of the greatest dynasties who ruled over India. This dynasty ruled between 6th to 13th century. Students, this dynasty ruled over almost entire Karnataka, Maharashtra, Andhra Pradesh, and some parts of Madhya Pradesh. Students, this dynasty was founded by Danti Durga. Danti Durga defeated the Chalukyas of Badami. Students, their capital was at Malkhed near Solapur. They allowed Muslim traders to settle there and permitted them to preach Islam in their dominions. The famous rock cut temple of Shiva at Ellora was built by the Rajputas. Now students, let us know about the tripartite struggle. The tripartite struggle was a struggle for power and control over the central Gangetic Valley among three major dynasties of India in 9th century. And these three major dynasties of India were the Pratiharas, the Rajputas, and the Palas. And you know students, these dynasties competed for control over Kannauj, because Kannauj was located in the central Gangetic Valley and it was a very important center for trade and commerce. Students, in this way, Kannauj became a center of attraction of various parts. Students, the Palas ruled the eastern part of India, the Pratiharas ruled the western India, and the Rajputas ruled over the Deccan region of India. Students, the major reason of this struggle was control over Kannauj, because the land of Gangetic Valley region was very fertile. And you know student, all these dynasties had a lust for war booty, which was an important source for maintaining a huge army. In this way students, this struggle weakened all the three dynasties. Causes of this struggle: to acquire supremacy over Kannauj as symbol of prestige, to control over the rich resources of the Gangetic Valley, to get control over Gujarat and Malwa, whose nearness to the coast was very important for foreign trade. Now students, I am going to explain the Rajput dynasty. First of all, I will tell meaning of the word Rajput. Students, the word Rajput has been derived from Sanskrit word Raja Putra. Raja means king and Putra means son. It means son of a king. Students, the Rajputs played an important role in the history of medieval India. They established their kingdoms in different parts of northern India. The most important of these were Parmars of Malwa, Chauhans of Ajmer, Gahadwals of Kannauj, Chalukyas of Gujarat and Tomars of Delhi. Students, the historians believe that the Rajputs descended from Shakas, Kushnas, Huns, Gurjars and Gonds. Students, the Rajputs were organized in different clans. Most of the Rajputs were supporters of Hinduism, and you know, they are considered to be Kshatriyas. Students, the Rajputs are divided into two Vanshas, Chandravanshi and Suryavanshi. Chandravanshi belonged to Moon's family and Suryavanshi belonged to Sun's family. Students, now I am going to explain the Pallava dynasty. Students, Pallava dynasty was a pastoral tribe who ruled the southern part of India like Andhra Pradesh, Karnataka and Tamil Nadu. Students, they ruled for almost 500 years. Their capital was at Kanchi. Students, you know, Kanchi was a city of temples and Vedic learning. Students, the founder of Pallava dynasty was Simha Vishnu, who was famous as a very efficient and strong ruler. Students, after his death, Mahendra Varman, his son, succeeded him. Students, they originally worked as officials under the Satavahanas rulers. Gradually, they established themselves as local rulers. Students, they had trade relationship with Southeast Asia and China. Students, their rule declined by the end of 19th century. Some of the rulers of this dynasty were Mahendra Varman I, Narasimha Varman I, Mahendra Varman II and Parameshwar Varman I. Students, the topic ends here now, and I am once again giving you a reminder, if you have not subscribed our new YouTube channel St. Xavier's School Hardoi, please subscribe our new YouTube channel St. Xavier's School Hardoi and press the bell icon for getting upcoming videos and notifications. Thank you for being with us.